Okay, it's on.
Hello everyone, this is Malika and Audrey and welcome back to Let's Unwind.
Let's unwind.
How are you, Audrey?
Me? How am I? Well, it's been a whirlwind. My mom was here and then she went back. Which was
really she's like, yeah, she was here and then she's not.
Yeah, well, she's no longer with me. And then now there's no more cooking, there's no more Singapore food. I have to cook myself, which is sad. So I'm lonely and I'm back to being lonely.
That is so depressing. Can you stop? You come into London in like a week, right? You're fine.
Yeah, I am coming back to London next week. I'm coming back to London next week. So
welcome home. See. I'm not going to be here to welcome you, but welcome.
I hate you so much. I wonder who will. But anyway, how are you?
That's a good question. We're going to hang on to that later. I am good. I'm good. Audrey and I spoke a little bit about, before we did this, about a whirlwind of emotions in my world as well. But like, it's been a kind of a morning, but I'm fine. I was in Glasgow last week, which was fun. I met with our best friends, our mutual friends, Audrey and mine. And we just like walked around in the gorgeous parks, ate delicious food, drank a lot of margaritas. And just, you know, spend time. And it was just very wholesome. So I had a lovely time.
Oh, that sounds lovely, lovely. And I mean, like, talking about last week, what did we talk about? We talked about loneliness.
We did.
Perfect.
Back to what we're feeling. Yay!
I mean, we talked about a bit about loneliness, which I think will be a very relevant topic for today. And and we talked about that. We talked about how we coped with it, what we can do about it, making friends. And we also talked about some resolutions, which is to meet new people.
That is true. Did you?
Well, I mean, with my mom here, it was kind of hard. I did speak to strangers, if that counts, saying hi and how are you, and just getting to know them once, you know, like, for 10 minutes, I guess.
Yeah. No, I was in Scotland as well. So it was easier because I used to go on walks by myself because my friends were working. And Audrey, you would not believe, like, I was literally in the University of Glasgow and I got lost. And like, there's this guy who comes and he's like, do you need help? I'm like, yes, please. I'm lost. I don't know how to go to the bus station. He's like, oh, I'll take you. And then he walks to me and he's like, oh, how are you? Where are you from? And he's like, oh, I'm from Dubai. And I'm like, no way. Walk me to the bus station. And then we just like stood there talking about his life. And I talked about like me potentially moving there. And he's like, oh, anything you need in Dubai in terms of X, Y, and Z, like I'm here. Then he sent me like a message on WhatsApp. Hi, Malika, here's my LinkedIn. Apologies for the delay because we could not find him on LinkedIn when I was there. And he said, encountering you was intriguing. You sound determined and focused. I'm confident you'll do wonders. And like, oh, that is adorable. And like, I met like so many more people. I'm not going to get into it right now, but like, yes, I did meet new people and I made new friends.
Well, that sounds like a very fantastic trip that you had to go to. I'm jealous just hearing about it.
Yeah,
and so I mean, like, I didn't personally meet anyone, but I mean, I have, since I moved into, you know, to this place a month ago, I have a new neighbor now. She moved in while I was still in London. So when I came back, she's here now. And we're going out for dinner just to get to know each other because we never had the chance to really get out and get to know each other one-on-one. And also at the same time, I met someone, like I said in the previous podcast, I met someone on Bumble BFF like 2 weeks ago. She said, like, you know, we have a few crazy nights together and, and just, we've just been hanging out. And I think like, you know, I mean, I've never really been one for the apps before, but I,
really?
No, I have not. Not even dating apps. I mean, I have gone on a bit, but not, you know, just never really put myself out there on the apps. I just never really saw, you know, an appeal.
No, I get it. I think for me, even like I was like that person, I'm going to meet people naturally, like in house parties and this and that. I think dating apps are just a great way to just like meet boys, not just people, boys in general. But like dating, I think it's very, very cool. And I think in 2023, I think we just overhype like natural ways of meeting and natural conversations. I think it's a generation of going out there to get what you want as opposed to just waiting. When I became recently unemployed, the week I was about to quit my job, or like it was my last week at work, I went on Bumble for the first time, I think, in like ages. And just started using it for like some time, like that week. And then I had like 5 dates scheduled for the next week. Like, it sounds like I'm doing some like meeting.
Malika, audition? No.
You never know. Like, it's a hit or a miss, you know, with these apps. Like, and it was not like, you know, like to find a boyfriend or whatever. Like, I'm not looking for a relationship. It's just to like genuinely just meet people and just have a good conversation. And that's about it. And I think dating in our 20s is already so hard and it's a struggle. We should not make it more hard by like putting down like unrealistic expectations on them.
Yeah, I mean, like, but when it comes down to dating, though, it's so hard dating in your 20s. I personally feel like everyone is out and about chasing what is important to them at the given moment. Priorities are different for everyone. I think to a certain extent, a priority will be, you know, like developing a career, especially we're so early in our 20s, you know, like finding, you know, just putting ourselves on the right path career-wise that, you know, we don't really have time or we don't really prioritize dating at this point. It's like, for us, it's like for fun. Everyone is different. Could be for fun, could be, you know, wanting something more. But I think, you know, the general consensus is that, you know, we have other things to focus on.
I totally agree. And that's why, like, it's interesting. And I was thinking about it myself when I was reflecting. I went into that job after coming out of a relationship. So, like, dating someone was the last thing on my mind. So I did not log on to, like, any app for, like, an entire year. I think there is just so much noise. There's so much stress in our 20s with, like, thinking about what to do and how to excel and, like, work stress and, like, new to the corporate life, that sometimes you do want to have or meet someone which, like, helps you block out that noise and someone who does not know a lot about you. Someone you can just talk to about, like, the stupidest or, like, the smallest of things without thinking about work in that moment. I know that's not a priority, but, like, it's only for fun, so you do know what to expect when you are looking for someone. I think I went on dates after, like, years because I was in a relationship when I came out of one or whatever. Like, properly, like, scheduling them and, like, literally going there with, like, a forced expectation. Like, it just feels good to just be, like, you know, treat like a queen, sit there, like, meet someone, just, like, have a good laugh, like, a few drinks and come back home. And I think that's literally what it was about. And I met some incredible people. And you actually meet friends as well. Like, you know, you never know.
You do. I think, like, when you go on these dates, sometimes you develop some sort of unexpected friendship instead of, you know, what you were there in the beginning to be there in the beginning for. The foundational pillar is, at the end of the day, you just want to meet someone new, whether or not they give you a new experience, a good experience, or a bad one. And I think, you know, that's the foundation of these dating apps and just going on dates in general, I say.
No, I agree. And I think something to everyone to keep in mind is, like, it's about, like, what you go in with, like, the expectation and, like, you have to go with an open mind and, like, know what you want out of that. And I think I was right that I was here to, like, have a good time. And if we click, fine. And if we don't, like, I had a good laugh, you had a good laugh, we had a few drinks and we are on our own anyway, you know? So I think it's about knowing what you want firstly and then going with an open mind about the same thing and being very clear about it.
No, 100%. I think communication and the communication of expectations are
massive.
Massive. You're right. You're completely massive. You know, we are 24, 25 next soon. And, you know, in our lives right now, I think it's more so because we're so focused on finding out what's next. You know, it goes back to the last episode of loneliness where you're left in a position where you have no choice but to meet new people. You know, you meet all these people, but only a bunch of them, only like a handful of them really stay with you or continue to make these new experiences with you. And I feel like because of that, a lot of people try to find partners to substitute that solitude, if you get what I mean.
I think you and me both, like, I think we are from a friend group where we are all very strong, independent, fierce, strong-headed girls, women, whatever. And I think we are like, no, we're independent and we want to go to the office and, like, be a boss bitch and, like, you know, like a boss lady and all that good stuff. And we don't need a guy and all that stuff.
Well, we're at home and unemployed at the moment.
No, it is. Low blow, Audrey. But anyway, it's the personality which talks more than, like, what you do, to be fair. But anyway, I feel like sometimes we discount the fact that it is just good to have someone to come back home to for a while. I think we sometimes we just want to like act strong, but I do not think there is any problem in wanting a partner. That goes back to like knowing what you want out of that. I think in our 20s, when time is rushing by, when you're saying like 24, 25, God knows what age, like the expectations about meeting a guy and then having a career and then having money and being financially independent. And if one of those boxes are ticked off, you just feel a little calm or calmer. Even if you're just seeing someone, that just makes you feel a little calmer because you're like, I don't have to like go on Bumble right now and like swipe left or right and like have a conversation. At least I have someone I can speak to and like that's fine for like a while.
It's having that constant partner next to you, knowing that like, you know, at the end of the day, he or she's the one that you want to come home to, and or he or she's the one that you want to, you know, talk your day with, and you have that constant with you by your side no matter everything else that you're facing in life. And I think a lot of people crave that because it's not very, it's not very normal today. You know, everyone's having
everyone's having
situationships. Everyone's having like one night stands. Everyone's having like, you know, on and off girlfriends or boyfriends. And it's just, it is a very fast paced world out there. And not a lot of people, you know, a lot of people crave that consistency in their lives.
No, I agree. And I think it all goes back to like the energy you would, like will attract. And that's why the situationships come into the picture. And I think this is what I've realized, that if you are very happy with yourself, and when you are at a stage where you're just happy with your friend group, with your family, where you're doing with your life professionally, and when you're like at peace, you'll be just so happy. You'll attract good energy because you will attract people who are happy with themselves as well. So you're fine on your own. You're just better together, happier together. But if you're this lonely, desperate girl on a date and you're like, I just need to find someone on this date, I can attract someone who will be like, oh my God, like whatever, like let's like, you know, go home for one night, like situationships. And that's why like it's just very important to attract good energy and being okay with yourself first before you go on these dates.
Apart from boys as well, I think it's super important to seek out relationships with the people around you and the existing relationships with your friends and your family and maintaining that, you know, I think maintaining friendships and family relationships in our 20s is also so hard, going back to that fast-paced life that we were talking about, that sometimes we lose track of the existing relationships we have with our friends, you know, with our parents, especially for both of us, where our parents are back home, far away. It's just super important to make sure and know that at the end of the day, like, these are your pillars of support. They've always been there for you and they will continue to be there. But it's you that has to maintain that. You do your part in maintaining that and making sure that you let them know you appreciate them. And I think that's really important.
Especially when you live abroad and you move from your small towns to your cities. Like there is like so many shiny things, including boys. Like one of those shiny things that you like attract and you're like, I want that. And you want to go out more and you want to like go and travel more. And you stop putting in effort to like see them, speak to them, talk to them, or maybe just make time for them. And I have learned this from personal experience where I have put a lot of relationships above my family. And like when push came to shove in terms of relationship, I put above them, like when that just like dismantled and was like poof, like disappeared in air. Like the only people standing behind me every single day without even like asking questions were my family. And like that is when you realize that no matter what happens, like this is a relationship that you have to like put the most effort in, no matter if you don't have to, you need to, because they deserve it. So I think I have now realized like it's just so important to just like just be in touch on good days or bad days and like do them by choice and not as a chore. And for now, like, I just crave to, like, just, like, you know, meet them. And that's why I think a part of me was very, very happy when I was like, maybe I'm going to move to Dubai because I'll be closer to home.
When you talked about your family, you really hit me, right? I mean, that's why my mom came to Spain in the first place.
Yeah.
My family has been my number one supporter through and throughout. And I'm very grateful for them. And sometimes you're right. Sometimes we take those for granted because they've always been by your side. And they, you know, they will never leave you. You know, they will always be there for you. So to some extent, you somehow take advantage of that and you take it for granted. And, you know, over the years, I've learned it via, you know, through various relationships that I've had, that I've taken my family for granted in the process of that. And, you know, of course, that mindset and that thought will not stay with you. Sometimes you are going to forget that you have family that are behind you. Sometimes you are going to forget that you have friends that are behind you. It's all about knowing who's going to be there for you. It's normal. I think when we're going through different stages in life, it's normal to to have that distance, you know, because naturally you're going to have that distance geographically, you're going to have that distance when you are in different stages in your lives as friends or in a relationship or family. You know, it's nice to not forget who you have behind you. And I think as life goes along, friendships ultimately become low maintenance as well. Life happens, people come and go, but at the end of the day, like, it's knowing who are with you all the way. But that said, you know, apart from appreciating all these friends and having, you know, having, you know, maintaining the existing network that you have, like, and it's super normal as well sometimes in life that you find new friends. And sometimes it's normal to leave some old friends behind, maybe because of some differences that you can't put behind anymore. Or sometimes it's just a different stage in life and you no longer, you know, like, the, you know, connect, you no them. Longer serve each other. Yeah, exactly. And I think it's very normal that friends, you know, people come and go in your life. People come for a reason and people go for a reason. I think
that's, I agree. I tell this to everyone. I feel like everyone is here. Like, your life's your book, right? And, like, people are there for certain chapters. Some people stay for, like, and they have special appearances in, like, most chapters till the very end of the book. And some people are there for a certain chapter, and, like, that's it. And they're meant for that chapter. You can't, like, prolong that. And I think it's not, like, ideal to, like, switch the page backwards as well. Like, I'm not that person. Like, if something is done, it's done. And I truly feel like there is no shame in wanting to make new friends. So I think it's knowing that some people are there to solve, like, to be there for a certain purpose as well. Like, they're friends for certain reasons. Like, you and I, we've been to university together. We've gone through so much together. So, like, I can travel with you, or we can, like, you know, do things like this. And they are friends, like, I want to meet, like, once in, like, 3 months. And that's completely fine as well. So I think it's just knowing what friendships are for what reason. And then also very important to, like, count the 5 or 6 friends on your hands that you know will be there for you, like, no matter what, and spending time to, like, serve them and put that effort and, like, water that friendship.
It's all about watering the plants that you have in your garden and making sure that you don't leave them out to die. I think that's very important. And it's time for me to start showing appreciation for the friends that
you
I
can
have.
Tell me you love me after the podcast, Audrey. That's completely fine.
Babe, I tell you, I love you every single day. What are you talking about?
I know. No, but I think, coming back to the point, I think, just to add to what you said very, very quickly, I think this is what I realized last week, actually. When I recently became unemployed, like, I remember how I was going on Bumble and dates and stuff, and I used to come back with, like, crazy stories. But I was also going to networking events as much. And the idea was to, like, meet people in, like, the industry that I potentially want to work in, and just, like, see if I can, you know, like, just, like, meet people through those events. And sometimes that is so exhausting. So something just to add in terms of me, like, watering existing friendships and, like, meeting new people is, like, knowing who to network with as well. Something that I have learned, and I'm still learning the hard way, is that you should just not network and make everyone in this world your friend. I'm sorry, it does not work that way. You have to be very, very careful about what friendships you water as well, because you have a limited time period, like, with you. Like, you don't have 24/7 to water friendships. Like, you have your own life, you have your own relationships, you have your own family, and then you have some time for your friends. And I would rather, like, grow and water, like, 6 people I want to grow with. I can't be friends with someone whose dream does not match mine. And once you have found those 3 or 4 or 5 people that matches your dream, your vibe, the path that you want to, like grow into or, like, take, I would spend, like, my 5 hours watering those 5 people in that friendship. We can grow together and we can help each other. Then spending those 5 hours watering, like, 25 different friendships where we all are in different parts of the world and we do not really know where we want to head to together.
You surround yourself with people who have the same ambitions as you. I think it's really important to surround yourself with people with the same ambitions, people with the same dreams, you know, people with the same drive as well to achieve those ambitions and those dreams. But when it comes to friends, sometimes I think I've learned this as well. Sometimes certain friends, no matter how close and no matter how valuable, will never have the same dreams as you. And I think that I found that very, I learned that, you know, because I have this friend of mine. She and I have completely different views about life. And she and I have completely different wants in life in terms of ambitions, goals, drive. But we still work, you get what I mean? Because we're always there for each other, regardless of whatever that comes in our way. And that is one of the friendships that I truly value as well, because regardless of our ambitions, we are, you know, she knows what I want, I know what she wants. We support each other in that way, you know. And I think sometimes it's important to surround yourself with those of the same ambition, but it's also important to surround yourself with those not of the same ambition, but are willing to support you through and through, knowing what your ambitions are.
No, that is very, very well put. Like, when I meant, like, surrounding yourself, like, it's more about, like, being friends with people with the same ambition. I meant people you meet in your 20s, because we meet so many people in our 20s and we still aspire to, like, meet more people. It's about choosing those who you want to grow with. But you will always have friendships from back home and they will not have the same ambitions as you. I have, like, two or three friends from back home and we don't have the same ambition at all. But they've seen me grow and they've been with me since day one and never gonna, like, leave them. But that's friendships, like, from your childhood, which you can never, like, let go of. And then the friendships in your 20s, which are so much more different, because they meet you from who you are as opposed to someone who sees you grow, you know?
Exactly, exactly. Well, I mean, I can't believe we did this, but we actually managed to wrap up relationships in half an hour when we thought that, or, well, at least 20 minutes, when we thought that it was going to take us a whole hour to go through this entire topic.
Honestly, guys, if I talk about those Bumble dates, we could talk about an hour, but I'm glad we did it in half an hour. Well, on that note, you guys, we are wrapping up Unwinding Relationships. So here's to meeting new people. And also being grateful for the old ones.
Yeah, exactly.
I agree.
Yeah. And on that note, right, let's do a resolution like we always do with every of our episodes. What shall our resolutions be?
Just being grateful. And I think we should just, like, show appreciation to our childhood friends and our tight-knit of friends we made in our 20s and our families. You should send your I love you to your mom right now and be like, thank you for coming over. I love you so much. Thank you for cooking me food. And I will do the same with my family and just being like, just thank you.
Well, a resolution for you from us to whoever who's listening, if you're listening to the end of this podcast.
If you are listening.
Go and say I love you to all the friends you cherish. Tell them how much they mean to you and just don't forget them, right? If it's a person that you really value, it's a person you cherish in your life and you want them to be in your life for the future, tell them. You know, what's there to lose? You're your friends.
We are you and your family. Guys. We love attention and we love love. And we just love I love you messages. Are just like, you mean to me, like you mean so much to me. Like, I had a friend who just sent me, like, I'm so grateful for you. Like, literally last week after I got him, like, that is like, that made my night and that made my day. So just make your friends day, family's day today. And yeah, we will catch up with you next week with another episode.
Exactly. We'll see you next Thursday. Thank you for tuning in for episode 3. This is Unwinding Relationships.
Much love. Bye.